Hello, are you wondering what the difference is between living in DC versus Maryland versus Virginia? Hi, I'm Melissa Terzis, DC Real Estate Mama, and on this channel we talk about all things Washington, DC, and also do a big push for DC with kids and dogs. If you're considering moving to Washington, DC, this video is going to help you compare living in the three different areas, DC or the city proper as we call it, as well as Maryland and Virginia. The three areas can actually be pretty different, so let's talk a little bit more about it. Let's start with lifestyle. DC is very walkable. I've walked from one neighborhood to the next, to the next, to the next. There's plenty of sidewalks, there's plenty of interesting architecture, plenty of interesting people to see and things to look at. I wouldn't say Virginia is known for being particularly pedestrian friendly. If you live in a neighborhood that's close to the city, like many parts of Arlington or Alexandria, then they can be walkable as well as if you hit, say, the trails that exist. But for the most part, the further out you get, you're gonna see that the walkability is gonna decline greatly and that people are much more car dependent. Maryland is similar to Virginia in that respect. It's much more car dependent as you get beyond the beltway. But for basic tasks like picking up food and running errands, you're probably gonna have to get in your car. But there's also tons of trails in Maryland too, if that's what you're looking for. So what's the social life like? So DC has places in practically every neighborhood for meeting up with friends, picking up some food, or grabbing a few things that you may need. You can do all of this mostly on foot. Maryland and Virginia nightlife is typically located in the centers of the specific neighborhoods. So if you take Clarendon or Courthouse, for instance, those areas have their own little shops and restaurants and places that you can go. Same thing with like Old Town and Alexandria. If you live close, you can do quite a bit on foot from eating to shopping. But once you're outside of these areas that are what we would call close in, your options are a little bit more reduced unless you're in one of the planned communities that's kind of popped up where it's more like live work. They're gonna have restaurants and retail and places for people to live as well. So same situation in Bethesda, Maryland. There's quite a few restaurants and a bit of nightlife here. Having lived in Maryland though, I can say that it's really not a place that people move when they're looking for a hopping nightlife, but it's better than it once was. So as shopping malls have kind of gone the way of the dinosaur, you've got a lot more of these open air places. Like I said, they're more like little cities that they've made, but they're planned communities, and they've popped up all over Maryland and Virginia. And then that sort of brings like a center to the little town or area or city that people would call now like a town center, and that's where you're gonna see people gathering and going for eating and socializing. So if you're looking for a place for your family to live, I would highly advise you to look at the schools first and then decide where in that neighborhood would be the best for you guys to live. If you're single and you don't have kids, the entire metro area is your oyster. Actually, not really. If you want to have a neighborhood that's 24/7 versus something that quiets down in the evenings, that's where you have to take into consideration if you want to be in the middle of DC or maybe a little bit out where you can actually like get some sleep at night and not have like a drunk person pounding on your window. It happens. What about real estate and what do you get for the money? So what's the average cost to buy, to rent? Let's just take an overall assumption here that we're focusing on sought after or more popular neighborhoods for this exercise. So one bedroom condos are going to be upwards of $400,000. That's DC. In Maryland, the closer you get to the city, you'll probably still pay in the 300s, and the price goes up down from there the further out you move. Virginia has caught up to DC. Thanks, Amazon. Thanks a lot. So single family homes in DC are in like the $1 to $2 million range at this point. Can you find stuff for less than that? Sure. There's a good portion of DC that's like what we would say is the up and coming neighborhoods. You may be able to get a small like two bedroom, one or two bath row house for $400,000, $500,000. When I say single family homes, I am talking about a row house. These are attached homes. They're not single family detached where you've got yards on all sides of you. There's not a lot of that here unless you get further out. In Virginia and Maryland, the home prices have held pace. I would say about an hour outside the city, you can maybe get to a home price that's like $600,000-$700,000-ish. And the further out you go, it will still go down a little bit more from there. But of course, there's always neighborhoods that vary in price based on land size and amenities and location. Rents follow the same patterns, with one bedrooms in DC renting for about $2,000 to $2,400. Two bedrooms are $3,000 to $4,500. In Maryland and Virginia, the prices for rent are going to probably be like 70 to 80% of the DC prices for a comparable home. All right. I hope this this video gave you a nice overview on the difference between living in DC, Maryland, and Virginia. There's definitely very, very personal opinions about where one wants to live when they move here. There's people that live in DC, and when they get maybe priced out, they have a very strong opinion about whether they're going to move to Maryland or Virginia. And I can't tell you why that is. It's just Virginia resonates more with some people and Maryland resonates more with the others. I have no idea. So if you have any additional questions about living in DC, let me know. My contact info is going to come up right after this. I am Melissa Terzis, DC Real Estate Mama with Arlo Real Estate. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my videos if you want to see more in the series. Thanks so much. Contact info incoming.